close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be creating this nude brownish kind of makeup look. This is extremely light on your skin and you can use this as your daily go-to kind of makeup. And if you really like this look, please do continue watching. And if you're watching me for the first time, don't forget to hit on the subscribe button below. Also click on the notification bell button so that you'll be notified on my video updates. So without further ado, let's get into the video.
I'm starting off with a primer from ELF. This is Mineral Infused Face Primer from ELF. And it's very important to use a primer before you apply foundation. Primer actually acts as a base for your makeup and which just smoothens all your open pores. And it also acts as a barrier between your skin and the makeup, and it does not allow your makeup to get penetrated into your skin. So it's very important to apply the primer. Today I'm gonna be using the orange corrector, and I'm using NY Bay orange corrector. The reason for orange corrector is that today I'm gonna be mixing two foundations. One is the exact shade of mine and one is lighter than my skin tone. So at times when you use a foundation which is lighter for your skin tone, it can turn out to gray. So to avoid that, I'm using this orange corrector. Also to hide out all my dark spots. First I'm using my finger to blend, after which I'm using a beauty blender to take the excess product out. These are the two foundations that I'm going to be using today. The first one is from Bayou Foundation and the second one is Maybelline's Fit Me Foundation. And the Bayou Foundation is a very, very high coverage foundation. It acts as a concealer as well. So I'm not going to be using any separate concealer today as this foundation acts as a concealer. So I'm going to be using this Bayou Foundation in places where I need my face to look brightened up. And I'm using this Maybelline's Fit Me Foundation in rest of my face and blending this nicely with a beauty blender. I'm applying this foundation my neck area as well so that it does not look as if someone else. We are going to move on to the eyes, and for eyes I'm going to be using Wet n Wild palette and Makeup Revolution palette, and I'm not going to use any kind of bright shade. I'm going to be using only the nude subtle kind of shades today, and from Wet n Wild I'm taking this burnt orange shade and then using this as my transition shade for today. And from Makeup Revolution I'm taking this dark brown. I'm depositing this brown color in the outer eyelid area and then blending this towards inner. And adding a little bit of dense to it. From the same palette, I'm taking this nude peach kind of shade and then using my fingers, I'm just applying this color in my center eyelid and then just blending this towards the inner corner. And this is going to be only from mid towards the inner corner, not the entire eyelid area. And I'm just using only my fingers, I'm not using any brush to deposit the colors. As this is a lighter color, I'm not getting the maximum pigmentation with a brush, so I'm using only the finger to blend this. Blend this very nicely, as nicely as possible, to avoid any kind of sharp lines in between. Now I'm taking the same burnt orange shade and then again using this as my transition shade, just adding a little bit of extra color to it and to smoothen out all the sharp lines. And I'm taking the same shade and then using not the same shade, the brown shade, and then applying this in my lower eyelid area, after which I'm just dusting off the excess products out with a brush. I'm using the same nude peach shade in the inner corner of my eyes as well as the brow bone area. This does not contain any kind of shimmer, just for this nude look. Now for eyebrows, I'm using Mesclair's pencil. This is in black shade. This is such a good pencil with jet black color, and the texture is completely in creamy one, and this is very easy to apply. The only thing is that when you apply using this pencil, use with lighter strokes so that you do not deposit any kind of extra darkness in a particular spot. This pencil has a combing brush in the cap, so I'm just using the same brush to comb my brows. To line my eyes, I'm using the Lakme 9-to-5 eyeliner. I'm going to draw a thin winged eyeliner with this. I'm using Lakme Iconic Kajal to line my lower waterline, and then I'm using a smudging brush to smudge the kajal so that it gives a smooth kind of finish. To add a little bit of volume to my lashes, I'm using the mascara from Faces Canada, and I'll be linking all the product details down in the description box, guys. If you need, you can check that. Today I'm feeling like my entire face is in same color, so to add a little bit of warmth and to enhance the tan, I'm gonna be using a bronzer today. I'm using the bronzer from NYX palette, so this is NYX contour palette, and I'm using the darker shade from that. I'm using this to bronze the jawline area and hollows of my cheekbones and my forehead, and then to define the structure of my nose. Now I'm gonna be using the highlighter from Wet n Wild. This is Wet n Wild Liquid Hello Halo highlighter, and the specialty of this highlighter is that it does not look as if you have applied a highlighter or extra shimmer on your cheek area, so this just gives a natural kind of glow. I'm just applying some tiny 3 dots in my cheekbone area and in my nose, and blending this nicely with a sponge. So blend this nicely and you'll get a natural glow. For blush, I'm using ELF blush palette, and I'm not going to be using any pink shade, and today I'm going to be using this nude shade. This just adds a little bit of tint to your cheek color. To line my lips, I'm using this Lakme nude brown shade. This lipstick is from Lakme and 9-to-5 range, and the shade is Caramel Cut. I've talked a lot about this shade in my previous videos, even in my beginner's makeup kit tutorial. I love this shade. This one of my favorite nude shade, and it looks fabulous in your everyday go-to kind of look.
I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and if you'd want me to create more makeup kind of videos, please do comment below. I'll see you all in my next video. Until then, take care and bye-bye.